Let's begin, let's begin. Story time, story time. We will read some books and we'll sing some songs. So let's begin, let's begin. Hello, hello, wonderful friends. How lovely it is to see you today. Oh, it's always lovely to see you every time we get together. Yes, it is. I think you know spending time with you is one of my very favorite things to do in all the world. Yes, it is. I'm so glad we're here today to hear some books and look at the pictures. There's somebody else that likes to listen to books and look at the pictures and really enjoys spending time with you. Someone who goes, who do you think that is? Who really enjoys spending time with you and snorts a lot? Oh, you think it might be Sally Pig? You've got a great idea there. That does sound just like Sally Pig. She loves spending time with you. Yes, she does. And she snorts a lot. She snorts all during the daytime. And she snorts during the night when she's fast asleep. Do you remember what that special word is for snorting when you're asleep? Right, it sounds almost the same as snorting. Snoring. That's something Sally does quite a bit of. Yes, she does. And sometimes I do too. Oh, well, it's a silly thing to do, to snort at night. What? Oh, we should look for Sally? That's a great idea. She's not down in my lap, and she's not over here on the red cushions, not by the books. And when I look out the window, she's not there either. Sally's nowhere around. She's going to be so sorry that she's missed you. Because like I said, she loves spending time with you. I guess we're just not going to be able to find out if she's the one that is extra special happy to spend time with you. What? Oh, I didn't look enough? There's other places to look? You've got a good point. I did look down, and I looked on my left-hand side, but I didn't look up. No, no Sally there. And I didn't look on my right-hand side, so I'll do that right now. And there she is. Here's Sally Pig. Thank you for suggesting that I keep looking. Oh, when I tried a little harder, I was able to find Sally Pig. Hi, Sally. Thanks for helping, friends. Sally is nodding to me and to you. Hey, Sally Pig, I'm glad I found you. I never would have been able to do it without our friend's help. We've got a question to ask you. Our friends think you're the one that goes and is so happy to see them. Are they right? Oh my goodness, Sally's nodding her head up and down. Do you remember what that means? Yes, you did. Nodding your head up and down is a wonderful way to say yes, yes, yes. And yes, 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 you were right. Sally Pig is the one that's so happy to see you. Yes, yes, yes. Look at her nodding away, saying yes. Oh, Sally, we love our friends, don't we? Sally's nodding yes again. We love our friends just a little tiny bit, isn't that right? Well, what was that? You just shook your head back and forth, back and forth. That's not yes. Yes goes up and down. What, friends? Oh my goodness! Sally and I both heard what you said, and Sally says, you're right. Oh my goodness, shaking your head back and forth doesn't mean yes. It's a great way to say no. No. Sally saying no, she doesn't love us just a little bit. Oh, what a silly, silly thing to say. Why would Sally say such a silly thing? Let's ask her. And let's ask her right now together. Will you help? Thank you. Ready? Let's say Sally's name 1, 2, 3 times together. Here we go. Sally, Sally, Sally. What do you mean? No, you don't love our friends just a little bit. That's so silly. Really?
What?
We both heard you again, and Sally says you're right again. You guys, Sally's such a tricky pig. She says, no, 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 no. She does not love us just a little bit, because just like you said, Sally loves you. So... she loves you so what? That's right, she loves you so much. Now Sally's nodding, yes. Oh, she was just tricking us all along, wonderful friends. Sally doesn't love us just a little bit. No, no, no. Because Sally loves you a whole lot. Yes, yes, yes. And I can see why she loves you so much. Look at you. You are so lovable. Yes, you are. Well, Sally, we got a bunch of books to read today. And I can't wait to start reading. I'm in the mood for reading. Are you in the mood for reading? What? Sally said no, she's not in the mood for reading. What do you think she wants to do? Sally says you're right. She heard you say that you think she's in the mood for singing. Now she's nodding her head up and down because that's what she is in the mood for. Oh, you say first singing, then reading? Yeah. And Sally would love it if you join in. Hey, Sally, that's a great idea. Let's sing together. We can clap together, too. Sally's going to use her hooves. But what can we clap with? Hands. Great idea. Here we go, friends.
I'm in the mood for singing. Hey, how about you? I'm in the mood for singing. Hey, how about you? I'm in the mood for singing. Singing along with you. Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that today. Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that.
That was wonderful. Let's
well,
do it some
I'm
more.
I'm in the mood for clapping. Hey, how about you?
Great job.
I'm in the mood for clapping.
Hey, how about you?
I'm in the mood for clapping. Clapping along with you. Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that today. Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that.
That was wonderful. What should we
and
do now?
And I'm in the mood for whistling.
Let's try it. Great job.
I'm in the mood for whistling.
Wow.
I'm in the mood for whistling. Whistling along with you.
Let's try it together.
Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that.
Let's clap together. Can you clap way up high? Oh, let's try to reach the sky. Great job. Can you clap down low and touch the ground? Yes, you can. How about clapping in the middle? Can you clap on your tummy? Oh, that tickles.
Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that today. Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that.
Are you ready?
I'm in the mood for stomping. Hey, how about you? I'm in the mood for stomping. Hey, how about you? I'm in the mood for stomping. Stomping along with you. Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that today. Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that.
That was
yes,
wonderful.
I'm in the mood for singing. Hey, how about you? I'm in the mood for singing. Hey, how about you? I'm in the mood for singing. Singing along with you. Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that today. Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that. Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that today. Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that. I'm in the mood for that. Oh, I'm in the mood. If you're in the mood, then we're in the mood for that.
Yippee! Hooray! Oh, I was in the mood for doing all those things. Clapping and singing and stomping, trying to whistle. And it was so much fun doing them with you. What, Sally? Oh, you had fun too? Yeah. And now, Sally would love to read, and so would I. All our stories today are going to be about a kind of food that I really enjoy. Pizza. Do you like pizza? Oh, yeah. A lot of people like pizza. Oh, look, here's a friend coming over to their house today. Oh, look, he's been to the grocery store. He's got a bag full of groceries. Oh, and the kids say, look, our friend is coming over to make pizza with us. Oh, my goodness. Look at the title. We're going to have a pizza party. Let's get started. This is the way we scoop and scoop, scoop and scoop, scoop and scoop. This is the way we scoop and pour when we make a pizza crust. Oh my goodness, flour and yeast, water. This is the way we pour some more, pour some more, pour some more. This is the way we fill and fill. Uh-oh, sometimes we spill and spill. That flour gets all over the place. This is the way we wipe the floor, sweep the floor. We clean and clean and clean some more when we make a pizza. Oh, it can be so messy. Oh, now let's make sure we have just the right amount of ingredients. Ingredients are the different kinds of foods and things that we put to make a special pizza. Or an ingredient is something that you use whenever you make any special kind of food. This is the way we fix and fix, fix and fix, fix and fix, fix. This is the way we fix and mix when we make a pizza. Oh, look, they're all stirring. And they've made the dough, the pizza dough. Now it's time to push the dough. Push and knead, push and knead. Now it's time to push and knead, push and push and knead. But we're not done. We push and poke, we roll and joke when we make a pizza. The dough is ready. It's not ready to bake yet. First, we have to let it rest. Yeah, we put it in the bowl and put a damp cloth over it. While the crust rests and rests, then we have to wait a while. While we wait, we play and play while we wait for the pizza crust. Then the dough is finally done. It's time to make the pizza. Oh, look it. They're reading and smiling, just like we are. Oh, let's put the pizza out on the flour table. Now it's time to pull and pull, pull and pull, pull and pull. Then it's time to toss and toss. We use our friend for that. He's got bigger arms and hands, so it works better when he does it. Oh, look it. He did a great job, and now he puts it right down on the pizza pan. Now it's time to stretch and stretch, stretch and stretch, stretch and stretch. Now it's time to stretch the crust, and then we add the sauce. Oh, look at that tomato-y pizza sauce. We're spreading it. Oh, we're going to put some different things on the pizza. Peppers, mozzarella cheese, sausage. This is the way we cut and cut, cut and cut, cut and cut. This is the way we shred and taste, then we spread on the pizza. Oh, they're making sure everything gets all over the top of the pizza. Now it's time to cook and cook, bake and cook, take a look. While we wait, we read a book, while we wait for our pizza. Oh, finally, it's done, yay, hooray, oh, what fun. Yum, 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 yum. Look, we've made our pizza. Oh, it's ready. Our grown-up friend takes it out of the oven. And when it's cooled off a little bit, cuts the pizzas right into slices. There's plenty. Now we'll eat our pizza. Yum, yum, yum. There is plenty for everyone. Oh, look at everyone making that pizza and then eating what they made. Great job. And oh, look at, they made sure to save some for their friend. Because you do need a grown-up, don't you, to help with the oven. Yes, you do. And he helped out a lot. That pizza came out great. Wow, they are great pizza cookers and great pizza bakers. Sometimes at my house, we do make a pizza at home, but sometimes we get a pizza from the pizza store, the pizza shop. Oh, we let somebody else make the pizza. This is a story about Pizza Pat. That's the title. And that's the name of this man who makes pizzas. He makes them for himself, and I think he makes them to sell to other people, too. That's his business. And here's our story. This is Pat. This is the tray that Pat bought. This is the dough all stretchy and floppy that lay on the tray that Pat bought. This is the sauce all gooey and gloppy that covered the dough all stretchy and floppy that lay on the tray that Pat bought. These are the sausages spicy and choppy that sat on the sauce all gooey and gloppy that covered the dough all stretchy and floppy that lay in the tray that Pat bought. This is the cheese all white and sloppy that topped the sausages spicy and choppy that sat on the sauce all gooey and gloppy that covered the dough all stretchy and floppy that lay in the tray that Pat bought. This is the oven. Look at that special pizza oven. 800 degrees! That cooked the pizza and melted the cheese that topped the sausages spicy and choppy that sat on the sauce all gooey and gloppy that covered the dough all stretchy and floppy that lay on the tray that Pat bought. This is the pizza all cooked and chewy, all spicy and sloppy and gloppy and gooey. What? These are the mice and all their friends and their cousins. Mice from the neighborhood, mice by the dozens. I think they've been smelling that pizza cooking. They stole the pizza, all cooked and chewy and spicy and sloppy and gloppy and gooey. It came from the oven, 800 degrees, that cooked the pizza and melted the cheese that topped the sausages, spicy and choppy, that sat on the sauce, all gooey and gloppy, that covered the dough, all stretchy and floppy, that lay on the tray that Pat bought. Naughty, naughty mice. They stole that pizza and ate it themselves. This is the tray that Pat bought. Ah, this is Pat. Oh, poor Pat. Happy mice. Look at their full tummies. Oh, my goodness. Pat is going to have to start all over again. And this time, Pat is going to watch that pizza carefully to make sure no mice steal it. Mm-hmm. Oh my goodness. Oh. I didn't know that mice liked pizza, did you? No, in this next story, look at. There's another mouse that loves pizza, but he's not going to steal it. No, 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 no. This story, the title is Pizza Mouse, and this mouse lives in New York City, right here. He's in Central Park, a big park that's in the middle of the city. And here is his story. The mouse is going to talk to us. He says, did you know some people are afraid of mice? Ah! Ugh! Some dogs like to chase mice. Woof, 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 woof. I think all cats try to catch mice. Meow, meow. I'm a mouse. So what? I live in the city. I look for food for me and my family. Oh, look, I'm going to go into this fancy restaurant. The waiter is serving the food. One of the rolls fell off the table. I got it. Thanks for the roll. I love a big mess because where there's a big mess, I can find lots to eat. Oh, look, somebody knocked over some trash or else it's too full. Oh, some strawberries, some soup, some watermelon, some pumpkin. Look out for the man. He doesn't want to share his garbage with me. Oh my goodness. Mouse has got to run away. Look out for cars! Look out for the bird! Screech, screech! I can hide in this box! Huh?
There's something in here already.
What is it? What do you think it is? Do you know what kind of box that is?
Yeah. Pizza!
Somebody threw away a delicious pizza pizza? Wow, that's pretty crazy. I'm not gonna let it go to waste. I'm gonna take that pizza home. I think I'll go on the subway. The subway is a train that's in a tunnel under the streets. Yep, look at him. He's holding that pizza as he goes down to the subway trains. Oh my goodness. Nobody's looking around to see that mouse carrying the piece of pizza. Look at that. They're so busy thinking about what they're doing. They don't see what looks like a piece of pizza walking along because the mouse is underneath. And the mouse says, I take the A train. That's the way home. Time to get off. Hey, don't step on my pizza. Oh, finally. Home at last. Hi, kids. Look what I brought for dinner. Oh, pizza! Thanks, Daddy. And one piece is plenty for the whole family to have a feast. A feast is a big meal. Oh my goodness. One piece of pizza. Four. Let's count and see how many mice. One daddy. And look at all these kids. One, two, three, four, five. And one in five makes one, two, three, four, five, six. And if mommy comes home, six and one more will make seven. Oh my goodness. People do love pizza. And I never knew that until I started reading these books with you. I guess mice love pizza too. Oh, here's somebody else that would love a piece of pizza. They're not making it at home. They're waiting for the delivery person to deliver. That means to bring the pizza from the pizza shop. The title of this story is Hi, Pizza Man. Mama, I'm so hungry. I know you're hungry, sweetie. It's so hard to wait for the pizza man to come. I promise he'll be here soon. What will you say when the doorbell rings and we open the door? I'll say, hi, pizza man. But what if it's not a pizza man? What if it's a pizza woman? Then what will you say? Hi, pizza woman. But what if it's not a pizza woman? What if it's a pizza kitty? Then what will you say? Row, row, pizza kitty. But what if it's not a pizza kitty? What if it's a pizza dog? Then what will you say? Woof, woof, pizza dog. But what if it's not a pizza dog? What if it's a pizza duck? Then what will you say? Quack, quack, pizza duck. But what if it's not a pizza duck? What if it's a pizza cow? Then what will you say? Mmm, mmm, pizza cow. But what if it's not a pizza cow? What if it's a pizza snake? Then what will you say? I'll say, whoops, oh, that's, sorry, we're not supposed to be there yet. I'll say, pizza snake. But what if it's not a pizza snake? What? You saw that page, what's coming next? That's right. What if it's a pizza dinosaur? Then what will you say? Roar, pizza dinosaur. Look at it, it's a stegosaurus. Ding dong.
Ding dong. Let's answer the door. Hi, pizza man. I'm so glad you're here. Because I'm starving.
Oh, my goodness.
And finally, she gets some pizza.
Oh, that pizza. Reading all those stories, it's making me hungry. Yum. I hope I have pizza soon. And I hope you get to have pizza soon, too, if you want it. Guess what, friends? We read one, two, three, comes after three, four books today, but that's all I have, so story time is over now, over now, over now, story time is over now, we had fun. Please come again next time, again next time, again next time. Please come again next time. We'll have more fun. But wait, wait. Our stories might be done, but story time's not over yet. We still have one more thing to do together. Do you remember what it is? That's right. Ring around the rosy. So for you there at home, if there's someone in the room with you that would like to do ring around the rosy, hold hands together, and while we sing, you can go round and round in circles. But if you're in the room by yourself, or if the people that are with you are busy doing something else and aren't ready to do Ring Around the Rosie right now, that's fine. Just grab a toy, or a doll, or stuffed animal, or hold on to your own wonderful self. However you decide to do Ring Around the Rosie, Sally and I will do it with you. You ready? Let's go. Ring around the rosy, a bucket full of posies, ashes, ashes, we all fall down. Oh, that was fun. What? Sally says she had fun too. What? But she'd love to do it again and go a little bit faster. Can you do that? Let's try. Ring around the rosy, a bucket full of posies, ashes, ashes, we all fall down. Oh, that was fantastic, friends. Sally says, please, please, one more time, the fastest of all. Let's go super duper fast right now. Ring around the rosy, a pocket full of posies, ashes, ashes, we all fall down. That was wonderful, dear friends. Hooray, hooray. Oh, we are finished for today now, but you know what? I'd love it if you remembered all the time. That's right. That's what I want you to remember. I want you to remember that until I see you again, I'll always love you, love you, love you. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope I see you again really soon. Bye-bye.